Shit with him.
Good. So graveyard, we have like two good options. From afar, you see Ramas approach. He seems worried.
Ah, there you are.
Hi, what's going on?
I need your help.
Oh, immediately, sir. How can I help you? Instinctively, I grasp my sword, but it is so heavy that it falls to the ground.
Ha 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 ha. You wouldn't intimidate anybody.
Ha 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 ha! I suppose not.
A watchman has accidentally dropped his keys to the Torzas grave into a hole. The Torzas family is very powerful in this area.
Yes, I've heard that.
Well, we don't have someone small enough to retrieve the keys.
Do I need to go and have a look?
Yes, and I'd be very grateful.
Except. I don't know. It's pretty... I said except.
Except.
It's pretty...
Except.
That too. Seriously, I am afraid.
I beg you. I know it is not easy that you have to conquer your fear.
Ramas grabs my hand and looks into my eyes. I can't say no to those anime eyes of his. I crawl into the hole that the keys fell into.
I love that rest in peace.
It's pretty dark. Just... It's like a word art.
Yeah. I love it so much.
R-I-P. And it's, like, embossed. It's not engraved.
Yeah.
That's, like, they stuck it, it's like puff paint. Like, you would use for fabric.
Yeah.
Great. Fortunately, I find the keys almost immediately. But as I grab for them, I feel a sharp pain shoot up my leg. My leg! Something has bitten me!
It's more likely a cut from a rock!
But it's bleeding!
Calm down. When you get back out, I have some ointment that will heal it quickly.
All right.
Thanks for all the hard work. You are really brave.
Thanks. The music stopped.
It did, just out of nowhere.
Yeah, I guess they just ran out. My health gets worse. I have to stay home and rest for a while. Great. I love doing that. Are all the jobs just the same?
What?
Are all the jobs just the same dice rolling thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
I came to congratulate you!
Really?
Yes, I didn't think you would do it, but I was wrong! To be a watchman, one must concentrate and pay attention to every single noise!
Thanks, I'm doing my best.
You lack a decent weapon, though. Maybe you'll be able to afford a better one day!
I can't help you with that, I'm just rich. Oh, I would love that!
I have to go! Have a good day!
He smiles warmly at me before leaving.
Ah!
As he turns, his foot catches on something.
What a
and
fucking
he
nerd!
Falls to the ground! He stands with some effort. Ramas, are you alright?
Yes, of course! It is nothing!
But you're limping! Let me help you.
How? Do you want to carry me? It's nothing! I'm not limping at all!
Let me help you. Unfortunately, I'm not strong enough to hold him up.
This isn't working. Just forget it.
I insist on helping him, but I stumble and we both fall to the ground. He lands on top of me, with his head next to mine. He doesn't move for a few seconds, and it looks like he's staring. I mean, look at his face!
Dopey-ass fucking face.
He suddenly snaps out of his reverie.
Everything okay?
Yes, but this is so embarrassing.
Don't worry. I can walk just fine.
I...
What?
I think I twisted my ankle.
Ha 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 ha. I understand. Come here.
It is his turn this time, and he has no problem lifting me.
Perfect. Oh, god dang.
He carries me to a nearby exit, and the music stops. And
it's just these kind of headphones.
Really?
Yeah.
Because they've never... Did you break my headphones by tying the cord into knots?
No!
But I feel my heart beating faster and faster with every step he takes.
Go home and rest! Take the day off!
Thanks again.
But I still have to work.
While patrolling, I see a familiar figure in the distance. It's Rhea. Oh no, maybe if I stand really still, she won't see me and she'll go away.
You there!
Who, me? What could she possibly want with me now?
Have you found a medallion on one of your patrols? Tell me!
What?
A gold medallion! I had it before last night's hunt. The zombies were pulling at... What?
There are zombies? I could feel the heavy, round object in my pocket. I did find a medallion earlier, but it had the crest of the noble family of Triberg. There was no way it belonged to her.
You have it, don't you? Give it to me now!
No, I'm gonna lie. No, I don't have it. She glares at me suspiciously. I take a step backwards, remembering how quick... Can I just arrest her?
You're hiding something? Are you lying to me?
No! Rhea runs at me and I scream! She instantly covers my mouth with her hand and pulls out her blade.
Shush! You'll wake the skeletons! Are you stupid, girl?
It's daytime. She just looks around the cemetery with her dagger ready. After several moments of silence, she lets me go.
Didn't the guards teach you ever anything? Never scream in a graveyard! You're on your own now. I have to keep looking, but I don't think about getting in my way.
That's almost what she said. I throw the token on the ground and I run away. Why do I not just turn it in?
But I don't think you got those points with her because of that. Whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
We're doing a really good job.
I have almost a whole heart.
Yeah, with ram ass.
With ram ass, yeah. Free. Health is superb. Yeah!
Random encounter.
Oh, the sun is about to rise, which means it is finally time to go home. It has been a very long night, but it was uneventful.
It's daytime.
It has been a very long night. Now it's over. It's daytime. The sun rose. What is that noise? I hear moaning and scraping in the tomb next to me. Oh no! A zombie? A skeleton? I'm not prepared to fight them. I have to get out of here. I break into a run, going as fast as I can away from the monster-filled tomb. I look over my shoulder to see if anything is following me. Ah! I run right into someone. Their hands wrap around my waist to catch me. I regain my balance and look up.
Oh!
Rhea? Yeah, I thought it would be the dude.
Me too. I was very, very surprised.
She pulls her hands from me instantly. I pant to catch my breath.
Why are you running like that? You're gonna get yourself hurt, you fool!
Monsters! Back there, in the tomb! I heard noises. Nah, that was just some guys fucking. Don't worry about it.
I see. This hour is dangerous indeed! Hurry home. This is no place for a girl like you!
Ask for escort.
Girl, you go on, can you?
Walk me home, babe. Rhea laughs and I blush. Was it that silly of a request? I'm serious, please. There may be more monsters along the way.
You really are weak-hearted. Why did you ever become a guard?
Hey, I'm just asking you for help.
I just really wanted to follow in my daddy's footsteps.
Aw. I'm sorry, I'm just asking you as one person to another for a little bit of help. If you're too selfish to care about anyone other than yourself, then...
Quiet! You'll wake the dead if you yell any louder!
I bite my lip. I didn't mean to yell at her, but I asked for her help and she just called me a coward in return. She brushes past me in a rush, but that was the way to...
Hurry up! The zombies aren't that slow!
She changed her mind. Rhea quickly walks down the path toward the front gate. I scurry up behind her, feeling completely safe with her as my protector. We walk in silence all the way to the edge of the cemetery. As we reach the front gate, I sigh in relief.
There you go.
She turns to leave, but I reach out and catch her by the arm. She stares at me like I'm crazy.
What are you?
I kiss Rhea on her cheek. My heart flutters as I do. Thank you, Rhea. You are my hero. I pull back to see her severely confused look, but her cheeks are rosy, which makes me smile for some reason. Good night, and be safe. She's utterly speechless.
Cute. Aww. cute, y'all.
That's really cute.
Yeah, if we didn't get hearts for that, that would have been crazy.
Oh, we did. Oh, we did. Got him. We got some hearts.
We got some hearts.
We have half a heart.
Yeah, yeah, we got some heart. At some point, we're going to have to, like, change our location to one of these two. I don't remember at what level of the hearts, though. I think it's, like,
so you go to either, like, blacksmith or...
Yeah.
Oh, there's, like, the advanced jobs?
Yeah.
And that's how you...
Great. Cops are crazy. They'll fuck you up.
Yeah, the unhealthy environment has significantly deteriorated my health and my morale. Can you just die if your health is too low?
They won't let you. I don't think
they just don't let you. I wish you could just do that. Just stay home from work for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Whenever you feel bad.
Like, I feel very sad.
I'm just gonna stay home for 3 weeks.
Oh my god, you fucking piss baby.
She is. She's a little delicate elf maiden.
But level grinding, so much fun. I love video games. Level grinding, great games, fun times. Hold on, I'm gonna start cheating.
Okay, sure.
So we can get more.
Yeah, that's fine. I'll just cut it out so that we're not a bad role model. A friend of mine is getting married.
Oh, God.
Apparently. She invited me. Unfortunately, she lives quite far away. Guess it doesn't matter.
Hello, a random encounter.
Time for a hard day of work. I enter the construction site of a new villa that we were hired to build. A worker gives me a blueprint, and I look over the dimensions. This house is huge. How big is that fountain? And there are two kitchens? We must be building for a king. Who is this villa for?
The Zendor family. They're paying us lots of money.
The Zendor elves? They're a famous noble family from the north. So they're going to move here? And in style, no less. I wish I had two kitchens.
Same. That's double the food.
I do have two kitchens, but there's no food in the one downstairs. I start working, setting up the frame of the house. After I pound the last nail into the wood, I'm blinded by a glittering light.
Ah!
I cover my eyes and see that the glint is coming from a shiny dress. Oh, yay! A beautiful blonde elf woman is standing nearby, watching me work. Hello? Who are you?
I am Tim Zendor.
Tim... The Zendor's only daughter. What is she doing here? She runs her delicate hand along the woodwork.
I just wanted to see how my new home was coming.
It's coming along very well. I think so, at least. We've all made excellent progress today, and we might even get to go home early. She nods, and then swats at her face. Eh, eh. She swats again and screams.
Bree! Oh, goodness, a bee!
She flails around, shaking her dress and screaming. Calm down, it's just a bug.
Seriously?
Yeah, what the... She doesn't calm down. She thrashes around and runs right into the framework I had just built. The wood creaks and she springs away from it in terror. Shortly after, I watch all my hard work splinter and fall to the ground. This is a really poorly constructed house. Now I have to rebuild it all.
I'm so sorry.
Reassure her. She's pretty. Don't worry. Please don't cry. I can fix this. I just need to work late today. The elf still looks like she's incredibly broken. Really, I can do an even better job than before. If someone as dainty as you can knock it down, then it was never good enough for your home anyway.
She's got some pretty fucking muscular arms.
She starts to brighten up, smirking.
That's true. If I can knock it down, then any light breeze that I have sent my home crashing down on top of me.
I just said that so that she'd feel better. I didn't mean to give her an excuse to say I'm a bad builder. It only fell down because she interrupted me before I could finish, that stupid bitch.
You should build better! I'm not paying you for crummy walls!
She's still smiling, but I feel insulted just the same.
Same.
Probably because she insulted me.
Now, this heat is killing me. Off to tea!
She spins around to leave, but as she does, she knocks away a supporting beam I had in place for another wall. It tumbles out, and the top half of the other wall leans to the side.
Oopsie! I should just leave.
You should.
Yeah. She bashfully prances away. I'm never going to be done with all this work. Why did she show up anyway? I should calm down. She's not used to being in the fray, but still. I look at all the work I have to redo and sigh.
Why are you so garbage at studying?
Why are all my characters so bad at studying?
God, I fucking love a grinding. Nothing's more fun than wasting my time.
Go to fucking work!
Well. See, now we have to go off work for, like, a million weeks. Because you made me pass out.
You can't just skip a day. Work.
Yes, you can. If it's hot outside, you can just skip work.
No, you can't.
Yes, you can. Excuse me, have you ever had a job?
Yes! I have a job, and you can't just not go to work.
Okay,
it's fucking
well, you
hot
don't
outside.
Live in fantasy elf land.
I am surprised I am not fired.
I mean, these clearly aren't, like, salaried jobs. You clearly just, like, show up for the day, and then they pay you for the day.
Yeah.
So.
Oh my god, what the fuck? You fucking fragile little bitch. Oh yay, I have to pay money to bureaucracy!
Bureaucracy? I love bureaucracy!
Next time on Hot Level?
Oh, let's see, after we rest for 3 weeks! Finally! Jesus Christ! It's my new arm already! I can't.
That's
I fucking forgot!